So at the time of this recording, there has been over 14,000 cases of the coronavirus, and that is rapidly growing. People are being asked to work from home. Companies are cutting people's hours. Stores in many cities are being asked to close. Restaurants are limited to deliveries. Bars cannot have gatherings. They're recommending no gatherings above 10 people. People are having to quarantine from their own families because they're health workers and they need to avoid contact with their family because they're working with people who could expose them to the coronavirus. And actors from Tom Hanks and his wife Rita Wilson to the man who canceled the apocalypse, Idris Elba, to Daniel Day Kim, have tested positive for the coronavirus. Putting a face on the virus for most Americans, since if you don't know anyone who has tested positive, if you haven't been witnessing it, it's hard to put a face on it when there were no names. And yet, it's understandable keeping that information private. But there are actual statewide lockdowns going on that could be hitting anytime soon in your own home state. And in the midst of this, Gal Gadot and many of her friends, actors and various celebrities, released this.
Hey guys, day 6 in self-quarantine, and I gotta say that these past few days got me feeling a bit philosophical. You know, this virus had affected the entire world, everyone. Doesn't matter who you are, where you're from, we're all in this together. Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try.
No hell below us.
Above us only sky.
Imagine all the people.
Living for today.
I know it was well-meaning, and so I really do want it to be understood that I like most of these people, and I'm not sitting here trying to just simply wag a finger and hate on them. I'm excited to see work that can come from them once we can go back to movie theaters. Or however the movie landscape gets changed. It could very well... This could be the end for a lot of businesses, and we may be finding ourselves rebuilding the arts into something new and how the arts are consumed. But of all the inspirational choices, this one feels really tone deaf. And I get that there are other celebrities who are being tone deaf in other ways. Evangeline Lilly and Vanessa Hudgens come to mind as people who've recently made statements that seemed at best insensitive in this day. But however, the real problem here is what was meant to be reassuring and inspiring. The song choice isn't in this event. Now, I'll be very honest. For years, I literally hated the song Imagine because it just felt like the epitome of pie in the sky, hippy dippy, ignores the reality of people type of songs. Over the years, I've kind of mellowed on it. I still think it's got some pretty ridiculous notions. The idea that we're just going to be able to all go, that all it should take is this song telling us to, you know, if we only, we could give up money and we could give up city, states, blah, 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 you know, we could stop believing in heaven. It's a nice notion, the idea that we could all come together and toss aside those differences, those things that build walls between us. And while I don't mean to say that it's impossible to do that to an extent, imagine is the least imaginative way to think that's ever going to be accomplished. Now, I can, as it stands, I can, it's a song I can enjoy more or less with those caveats. Now, I was never the biggest John Lennon fan. I have his music. I prefer Paul McCartney's stylings over him. And actually, to be really honest, my favorite Beatles are George Harrison and Ringo Starr. I love their songs. And Ringo Starr does the kind of, he does the hippy-dippy love stuff too, but he does it in a way that doesn't feel as ridiculously huge. When he's doing it, it's more just about let's show each other love and compassion. That's not nearly as big as saying, imagine your religion doesn't exist. Now, some people hit on, you know, that not everybody's the best singer in this, and I don't really care about that. I mean, honestly, a better song choice might have been fine, might have been even inspirational, and give us a little bright spot in our day. But the problem with the song choice of Imagine in the middle of this pandemic is how uncertain everything is for people. There's a lot of people who are losing their jobs now. There are a lot of people that don't know if they're going to be able to feed their families, keep their house. Their future looks grim and it looks very scary. And that's not even including staying healthy. And some of those families are being kept apart by this. And you've got people who just don't share those worries, singing a song about imagine there was no money and no borders, no countries, no religion to divide us. But these are people who don't share those worries. They may have, I'm not saying they don't have fears, and I'm not saying they aren't probably all donating to help. I believe they are. I believe plenty of the people in the video are active. They just thought this would be a nice thing. But none of them really are in the fear of losing everything, and especially their families, and especially their homes, and especially their jobs. It's not just tone deaf, it's rich people living in large homes or condos or even fancy hotel rooms who are now singing a song to inspire us that just says, imagine all your worries and fears didn't exist. Guys, it was a bad move on their part. And I know there's a lot of people out there trying to argue, hey, they were just, cut them slack because they were just trying to be inspirational. But I am cutting them slack. I don't think they're evil. I don't think they're hideous for this. I just think this was tone deaf enough that it needs to be talked about. I'm not calling for them to be cast into a pit of hellfire. I am not approaching this from a idea that these people did something just abysmally horrible. I just think that right now people need as much hope as they can get. And a bunch of famous people without the insecurities for their future, telling people who honestly just don't know what tomorrow's gonna bring. Again, people are being laid off. People are losing their jobs. Husbands and wives, boyfriends and girlfriends, parents are suddenly finding themselves with no income because both spouses are gone. And when you start looking beyond that, the small time entertainers who aren't famous celebrities, or people who are, you know, maybe low-key internet famous, but still they've had their nose to the grind and suddenly don't have lost gigs, you know, comedy gigs everywhere and live shows, and they're just trying to make things come together. And beyond that, I mean, I can't imagine what this is doing for people who are in very much marginalized groups. I mean, it's hard to find work for people who are openly trans. That's a common fact, that it can be very difficult in certain areas of the country to find work. And if you're fired, to have to go on the job hunt in a situation like this to try and figure out where your money's going to come from when you're marginalized, that's even worse. Because I got to be up front here. I'm not approaching this from, gee, I could lose everything. I have no spouse. I have no kids. I know I'm going to be able to make my payments. I know I have a job because I've always been able to work remotely in the job I have. And this isn't me being upset by my uncertainty. This is me looking at people I follow on social media who are suddenly jobless, people who have to try and figure out how they're going to take care of their kids, people trying to deal with the stress of suddenly being home, stuck in their houses. It's heartbreaking seeing the uncertainty and struggle, and by God, pretending those struggles have no meaning to be inspirational, because that's really what Imagine does. It downplays the stress of our current system. I don't really know how to end this. So here's what I want to say. Celebrities, you want to inspire people. You want to make things a little brighter. You have the means that a lot of us don't. And I'm saying that as someone who's trying to find ways to support people where I can. But you have a means to do more. And there have been I've seen some folks go on Twitter where they're like giving people $20 into their PayPal accounts or $200 into their PayPal accounts until they reach a certain number. I've seen people go upwards to $5,000 or more. And do that. But search, instead of recording an honestly vapid sounding song in these times, find people who need some assurance that they're gonna be able to feed their families or pay their rent and not be homeless. Please. I know people will be skeptical and say to you, huh, you're just doing that to look good. Great. Make me skeptical of that. Just do it. Make lives better through action that can give them hope and comfort. And for the rest of us, try and support where you can. So, let's just call this the end of this first video since 2018. And my goal is to do some more videos this year then, and kind of get things going. I'm trying to get my reviews back on track. In fact, one of my videos will be kind of explaining what caused me to pull back last year during Christmas time. It includes meditations on the Joker. And so that's trippingthroughgateways.com. You can also find me on Twitter at Tom Wade. That's T-H-O-M-W-A-D-E. And also, I have recently set up a coffee page, which is at ko-fi.com/TomWade0243. And there is a link in the about page for that as well. Please feel free to hit the like button. You don't have to, but it'd be nice. Subscribe. Maybe we can get me up to 10 subscribers before December. I don't know. And then even hit the bell and you'll be notified whenever that next video comes out in 2022. Thanks for listening if you got this far. And again, let's support each other. Let's reach out. And for those with much, please give much. Thanks a lot. And hold tight. Hold tight in the weeks to come as best we can. And I only hope that we can weather this together.